A very good morning to all of you. I'll break protocol a little bit with the concurrence of Mr. Tushar Mehta and address Mr. Solie Sarabji, former Attorney General of India and the Doyen of the Indian Bar, Shri Tushar Mehta, Solicitor General to the Government of India, Shri Praveen H. Parekh, Senior Advocate and President of the Confederation of Indian Bar, Shri Pradeep Rai, Senior Advocate. Well, this has become a norm, virtual favors. I've become so used to them that I don't think I'll be comfortable in a normal favor. I've heard the speeches of both Mr. Solie Sarabji, Tushar Mehta, as also that of Mr. Praveen Parekh. You have been very complimentary to me and very gracious and magnanimous in your praise. I don't think I deserve all that, but I accept it with humility. What is the role of a judge? I think the role of a judge is to be one, to be true to the Constitution, true to his oath, and follow the Constitution and the laws. And also, a judge must dispense justice. I have found that in my almost 42 years in the profession, both at the bar and at the bench, that if your approach is a more clear-cut, honest approach, you always do a better job, both as a lawyer as well as a judge. I have been greatly influenced by Justice P.D. Desai, who was Chief Justice of my court for many years. I was a young member with hardly 5 years in the profession when he came as Chief Justice. He was our Chief Justice for 10 years. And in that period of 5 years, he was our Chief Justice for 5 years. And during that period of 5 years, I found that he left an impact not only on me, but on the entire judicial system of Himachal Pradesh. And his biggest impact was that when people come to court, they don't come because they enjoy coming to court. There may be one or two, what do we call, litigants who really enjoy coming to court. But 99% come because they are in trouble. It is not easy for a poor Indian to reach the court. Therefore, it is essential for both the members of the bar and the bench to realize that we need to be sensitive to the needs of the litigants, understand his problem, advise the litigant properly, and if a case has to be filed, then tell him what is likely to happen in a fair manner. And in all event, the judge also, if he is looking at it in that manner, will give him relief. I know I'm talking to the Confederation of the Indian Bar, which normally consists of very leaders of the bar, but I think this is something which applies across the board. Mr. Sarabji has talked about this aspect of people getting justice. They expect justice because they still have confidence in the courts. And they have confidence in the courts not only because of what the judges do, but also the manner in which lawyers play a part. The judicial system will be incomplete without lawyers. So the duty of the lawyers is also as important as that of judges. And I do feel that if the lawyers also actually look at the matters in a more objective fashion and not get only influenced by what their client says, we would be able to give a better system of justice. To have confidence in the judicial system, the clients must feel they have been heard. And therefore, I have always felt that if you give hearing to a lawyer, it is a much easier task. Mr. Tushar Mehta talked about my role as a humane judge or also my role in the environment. He also talked about balancing liberal views. I have been an activist judge. I am an unapologetic activist judge. But I have limited my activism mainly to two fields. One is social justice and the second is the environment. And when we talk of judicial activism in the field of social justice, you will realize that almost in all the cases decided, the courts have not laid down any policies. Very rarely it has been done. What we have always done is that these are the policies of the state government, these are the policies of the central government, why are they not being implemented? So we've never stepped outside the zone to which the judiciary is confined with. Similarly, but in the field of environment, we have always we've always done what we felt the law requires us to do, mostly in accordance with the environment laws and especially with the EIA notifications of 1994 and 2006. Non-compliance of those obviously is a violation of the laws. But, and I say it without reservation, environment is a fast-growing field. And in these fields, sometimes the court have done some legislation making or some, but that has been done only when the field is lying vacant. We have also made certain conditions late, we have continuing mandamuses for many years, but I strongly feel that if T.N. Godavarman was not here today, if the case was not pending, our forest would have been denuded to a very, very large extent. I have a lot of friends among the forest officials, and they always tell me that please don't let T.N. Godavarman be decided totally one way or the other. We need to do this in the larger interest of the country. I can say it candidly that I have always had a soft corner for the junior members of the bar. And why I have this is because two of my Chief Justices, Justice V.D. Mishra and Justice P.D. Desai, always gave an impetus to the junior members. They encouraged us. Dressing down in court, and in the evening you felt you should leave the profession. But the encouragement you got was something which helped me to develop into a fairly good lawyer and a fairly good judge. And I think it is that which I want to only transfer. What I've got, I've only transferred it to the junior members of the bar. I have been and continue to be a little strict with the senior members, because I think they don't deserve that extra bit which a junior member deserves. I have been overwhelmed with the love and affection which members of the bar have shown to me, not only in these farewells, but in the hundreds and hundreds of messages and letters, emails, which I have been getting. And I really don't know why the members of the bar have actually fallen in love with me, to say, in a sense. I have been a tough judge in certain ways, but all this is one thing which I followed all my life, is that a judge must be fair with the members of the bar. What does the bar want? A decent hearing, a judge who is able to get over his prejudices and even change his mind after hearing counsel. A judge who is pleasant to give dates, who doesn't insist on something like this, I'll give a date and I won't change it for anything. And these few things, and a judge overall who's fair and treats all members of the bar alike. I've always done that, and I think that's helped me. And I think it makes work easier and faster. I just recall an incident when I just joined I luckily became a senior judge within one and a half years of being appointed a judge, and I was presiding over DB, and one of my brother judges, who's otherwise a very good, very honest, very hardworking judge, fought with a lawyer for almost 15 minutes over a date. So when we came back, rose after, at lunchtime, I said, "Sir, if you'd given me 2 minutes to give him dates, in those 15 minutes we could have disposed of three other matters." So this is what I felt how the court should be dealt with. And no judge can perform his duties without the cooperation of the bar. And therefore, I'm very, very grateful to and thankful to all the members of the bar and all the executive members of the Confederation of Indian Bar. See, what I am going to miss is the dinner and drinks which follow a normal farewell by the Confederation of the Indian Bar held at the India International Center. I would have had enjoyed the company of all of you in that, but I am quite sure that after the lockdown lifts, we can have a good time together. Thank you very much for hearing me and giving me this favor. Thank you.